Adversary mode. It's not something I'm good at, or at least not proven to be good at, which I don't really understand, because I'm good at, like, TF2. Extraction form. Well, let's try extractions, whatever that is. But this is where the money's to be made right now. They're doing the whole double RP thing, I think. If this doesn't come up, double RP, double money, then I'm probably out. I need... It is! Okay, this is double money. And nobody likes to do this. Executive jets gone down the wrong part of town. Bodyguards work with their team member, the target, to rendezvous in the extraction zone, get to the evac point hit squad, which will be a one-person hit squad. You have an on-call host. How the heck does that work? I'm serious. I mean, the host is supposed to be the person who pulls the trigger. Everybody's on call but me, and I'm like, how does this work? I'm honestly confused. The only reason I want to do this is I need about 60 grand so I could get an apartment for my office. Accommodations, as they call it. And I've only got 2 days to do that. Which all I have to do is grind about seven races. How the heck do you have an on-call host? And that's how that works. Eventually I become the host. Three people. You've been kicked from the mission. There were not enough Headhunter, protect the targets. Okay. I could do a headhunter mission. This just comes... I don't even know how to do this. Supposedly you can make money doing headhunter missions. I'm out in the middle of nowhere. Where are the targets? Alright, let's just get... Let's get down the town and around town here. I'm apparently on the protect the target team, which is rather unlucky because I'm just dumped out of that game in the middle of nowhere. Seriously? Seriously, yeah, that's... Not the best handling car, but, you know, it'll do its thing. Oh, so many people in my way. But you can see, it is pretty well armored. I can ram through stuff with this for the most part. I'm going through here killing innocent people because lives are at stake. Oddly enough, I don't see a timer on this. I don't know if I'm in or not. I see the blue targets, and some have been told to protect them. Thank you for turning without a blinker. Still wailing down trying to get to the little blue guy. I don't even know what the little blue guy is. Okay, wait a minute. Let's see. Is there a closer target? Yeah, that target. Oh no, he's just off in the distance. Maybe I'm not really involved in this. See, that just pops up. VIP work over. They assassinated all the targets. So this is so far. Trying to do this stuff has been a complete waste of time. Complete and total. This will be a good place to park for right now, because we're going to try and... Let's try this mode. Jobs. Play job. Rockstar created. Adversary mode. Entourage 1. Yeah... Yeah, I know I'm supposed to, you know, jack the number of rounds up for more money, but I mean, for right now, I don't even know how much time I've got. I really have to fix my base logo there. That looks really cool blown up if it's not on a white background. So we've got people invited. And nobody's joining. Somebody come and play. Somebody come and play today. One more person come and laugh the laughs and shoot my kneecaps. It won't take long. Okay. Got two, we need three. We got two, we need three. This guy's gonna get depressed and leave pretty soon, I think. Inviting more players, gathering more players. Come on. Come on, Galaxy and Bounty Griefer. You know, when you can do double points, double money. And it's like 6 o'clock on a Wednesday. And not AM. And nobody wants to do it. I'm saying that this is not a popular game mode. It's not what I want to play. I just wanted to make some money. I have a feeling so I'm going to abandon this and go back to my standard solo racing kind of thing. Okay, someone here. Donut Cornwallis. Alright, we've got at least one other person joining. You'd like them if they go away. Yeah, we've seen Galaxy before. Let's just pull the trigger on this. Basically, we have one target, one bodyguard, one assassin. One, and apparently I'm the assassin. There's the bodyguard. There's the target. And I don't even care if I win this, because you make a pretty good amount of money losing. I like to win, but I don't really expect it, because I usually just get shot in the head repeatedly, and... You are on the assassin's team. See? I mean, this is like, you know... I can't even see the guys. I'm trying to take cover. I can die an unlimited amount. I don't like this mode. I shot that guy with a shotgun at pretty medium range. I I stick my head out here, I'm going to take it right in the neck. This is, like, pointless. I mean, we should be able to exchange some fire. I'm hitting them. I should just say the heck with it. Just walk away. Let's see, where the heck are they? Coming up this way, alright. I think they have to go over here. So what we should do is duck down. I think that's my heaviest. Move over a little bit. Seriously? I can barely be seen. This is why I hate this game mode. But, in the end result, I will get like, I don't know, 8 grand or something from this. I thought that was the point of it. All right, loser. That was great. Well, hopefully they feel good about themselves. And 33. That's all. There's 3 grand. Now, what you'll see is I suck exactly as badly on the other side for some reason, because somehow when I face this lone assassin, he's going to be able to like completely gun me 75 rounds in the head instantly. Okay. I am apparently the bodyguard because I've got the baseball cap. Now, let's see. This guy knows enough to set the destination here. They should be coming from that way. Where'd he go?
Careful.
Hit the health. Probably. Oh, there's some... I'm in it for the money.
The right side.
He got him. See, I'm not doing wonderfully here. He's trying to He's trying to flank behind us. He's on a roof. See? I'm just terrible. I did get an extra life. I hit them, but it doesn't matter.
Behind you.
Yeah, well, there's some money. I ranked up. Yay. Target winners. Yay. I guess he won 2 rounds. Like, I don't even know how that works. We'll click like, although just to say like. He liked it. All right. Are we going to do this again? Are we going to try again? Meet with more people? Cola Locola 3 round. Okay, well, let's see what they pick. Okay, well, it's 2-3. It's guess we're doing. I don't know. Have I done Entourage 3? I must have. Okay, so we want 3 rounds. We can do that. Well, this should be a little more even. Although, to be honest, I'm still gonna suck. So, I mean, that means I'm probably gonna get killed. Unless I got a really good teammate. And we're the assassins. There's the bodyguard and a guy. And it's continuing. I don't know what we have to do. There, someone was waiting. They're gearing themselves up. Round run, Entourage 3. Looks like they're shooting at us already. Or they're shooting randomly. Yep. Where the heck are they? Okay, well, at least I wasn't the first blood. I mean, I took cover, I fired. Okay, we gotta get out. I can't even see this dude. I mean, I literally cannot see them. I've got nothing scoped. I can't understand why this mode isn't more popular. What the heck is that? I hit him, but that doesn't really matter, because he's got, like, you know, armor and stuff. I can't even get the... The We're gonna call this video "What's Wrong with, you know, Entourage," basically. Down. Oh, somebody made it through the roof. Maybe I've distracted them enough. I make a good distraction. Guess we're both gonna try the flanking thing, or you know a way upstairs? I say that rhetorically, I'm not actually. With one bullet basically. Man, I know we're not supposed to be, you know, we're supposed to be unlimited assassins and stuff like that, but man, this is like insta-death. I really don't. I don't know why my bullets are like. Just spray and pray. That's all you can do. Why is stuff just blowing up like crazy? Right, that's just not gonna work. Is there a ladder? Something. They're getting on the darned helicopter anyway. Well, that was just disappointing. You might say, why are you even showing us this Black Knight? It's just pathetic. I mean, you guys have seen my other videos. You know I know how to actually shoot. And now I'm the target. This don't necessarily end well. Okay, I'm gonna set the location on my map. So he can see it. I assisted. I did hit. Okay, let's get down. That he doesn't even take cover properly. Flanked us. Okay, I've got the. We gotta keep moving. I get headshot here. Why does this never happen when I'm on the Assassin's team? You have any inventory? We have nothing. Crouch? I don't even know the crouch button. Double loser. I don't like this game. I realize there's probably some better strategy to this than what I was trying to do, is keep moving forward. But the idea was great. Now I'm going to die 17 times, get another 3 grand. Or 10 grand, maybe. And after this, I'm out. I'm going back to... Maybe I'll show you how I usually make money. He's already dead. That's it, I'm running. Absolutely running away. Here's a ladder. The only thing I can say is that there's a good chance that people don't think vertically. If I can get up a little higher, while he continues just to shoot at them, lacking a scope, this is really hard. I'm a hard target from here. My health coming back low. Oh, man. That was so much work to get up there. Can I climb this wall? Get in here some way? Is there an up way to climb up the... No. He's flanking. And it's not going well. I'm running right around. Oh! He shot me in the elbow! Okay, I'm aiming the wrong way here. That was an attempt at cover fire, also known as praying to God that you hit something. I have not gotten a single kill. I may have gotten a couple assists. I think it's up to me. And we lose. Match loser! Yay! 17 grand, though. See, you're the match loser, you still get 17 grand. Double play weekend. That's how you grind. I like the 17 grand. It says I only got 5,700. I don't know what's wrong there. How much do I have, I wonder? Oh, here you are. There's the overall result. So overall, from the whole thing, 17 grand? Is it worth it? If we were the winners, then I would have had actually enough. I don't want that one. Dad, you know, this is just too painful. Good game, guys. I'm so done with it. Okay, so we're at least back on the ground here. In a bad part of town. You never know when people want to continue the fight after the fight's over, so you have to keep moving. I'm going to now... So I made 30 grand out of that whole effort. Play jobs, bookmarked, races, Bahama West Mamma Mia, that's the one. And I have no idea how to link to this in like the description. Made by Bob Chili, Land Race, Rockstar Verified. Two laps is all you need to max it out. We'll pick compacts for right now. We'll use the Mirthmobile. Confirm the settings. Play it by myself. Busta, the SE. There it is, the Mirthmobile. And I know I've shown this in other videos, but I'm just kind of comparing and contrasting here. The previous part of this was painful. Okay, it just was painful. It was agony. It was $30,000, and I think it's an interesting thing. I'm going to look at the time on this and look at the dollars per minute from a double RP Entourage versus what I get from this. Now, you might say to yourself, Black Knight, why not just take the easy way out? Easy way. Buy a shark card. Because right now I probably would need about 1.2 million just to get all the things from my apartment at half price. My accommodations in my new CEO office. But on the other hand, that's, you know, $19.99 plus tax. That is actual money that can be used for things like, oh, I don't know, food. Now, if you work out how much I'm making per hour in not spending that, actually, you can say to yourself, well, this doesn't make sense. You're making 30 cents an hour playing this game. But I'm still making, like, 30 cents or whatever it actually works out to be playing the game. As opposed to spending money on it. You know, so it's like, you know, I've done shark cards in the past when I thought the Frankenstein was going to be a limited edition item. I actually did get a shark card. And there was a shark card sale going on, where you got a whole bunch of extra money for it. I got 3 or 4 million out of that for the 20 bucks. But, and I don't want to say that I have a problem with people who buy shark cards. I mean, that helps the development of the game. It's just that I have other uses for it. You know, this is not the point in my life where I can be doing a whole lot of shark cards. Now, does that mean I'll never buy another shark card? That's probably not true. There's a very good chance that I'll buy one soon, for all I know. There's a couple things I want to do. Like this, getting this, you know, thing up here, you know, all set up in the Maze Bank. Now, you might say, what are you doing? You've stopped. Well, right now the time is at 2 minutes, 4 seconds. And if I wait until it hits 8 minutes, then I'll get 8408. So, you know, let's, we can even do a little math on this here, you know. That is... $8,408 divided by 8 minutes. So you're making $1,051 per minute. Now, obviously I don't know how much time I spent getting that 30,000, but it feels like it had to be at least a half an hour. Let's, you know, we'll put the real numbers up here. And the real dollar per minute here. And now, consider that's with double dollars. So the real numbers would be... So now here's how you can compare, you know, Entourage with just sitting in a Rhapsody on an empty street waiting for the timer to go. Now I could do bills, I can make coffee, I can, you know... In one video I did this making hot dogs. I did something making hot dogs. I think this was what it was. So what I can do is now you can go on with life. You can, you know, grind this through. Now you have to watch, because if you let go more than 15 minutes, it kicks you. So oftentimes what I will do is I will turn the car, let's say, this way. Ooh, you can hear the music inside the club. It'd be nice if they would open this up. That would be a great area. Push the W key down. Lean a screwdriver on the keyboard. And let's see if I can get a picture of that here. We'll superimpose that on the screen if we can. Do the whole pig dance. Let's. I got time. I mean, I'm actually taking the picture now. It's like, if it flash off, because that's just causing so many reflections. There you have it. We'll do a little video. There we have it. As you can see, it is holding the key down. And you might say, well, what's the advantage of this? Well, the advantage of this, my friends, is that now I can walk away for an hour. Car's still going to be there. The game still thinks I'm playing. And so if you have stuff to do, you just set this up, walk back, and then... you got yourself money whenever you have the availability of doing that. This also works for bounties, by the way. You go into a solo session, park a car, spin the tires for a day, come back, you're fine. So on that note, I will see you in 3 minutes. And here we are at 7:35. The time is counting down. Might as well get in a position to make some money. Go, 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 go. Here we go. All right, we got 8 minutes in. So as far as shark cards are concerned, I think we're talking, do you have the disposable income? Or do you want to spend that disposable income on other things? I mean, it is the summer. We've got all kinds of things going on. And you're saying, well, gee, if you have other things going on, are you going to spend your time grinding money in a Rhapsody as opposed to actually doing other things? At some point, you got to walk away from the game, too. And say, well, I got other things to do. But there's one other thing I will show you that's kind of fun. It all comes down to what are your priorities? If you have the money and you don't have the time, then hey, get yourself a whole bunch of shark cards. Go to town. If you're saying to yourself, well, where'd my bike go? I have a bike. Where's my custom? There it is. But if it's something like this, and it's like you need money in a short period of time, you can get the card, or you can try some of these tricks. If you're home doing the bills or having dinner, you can just put that screwdriver on the keyboard. As long as the kids don't pull it down on themselves, you know, that's... I'm finding, you know, with the small kids around, you can't really put a sharp object on this keyboard, because then they'll try and pull the keyboard down on themselves. No, you can't do it. So we haven't had that happen yet, but, you know, these are things you have to watch out for. And, of course, you know, I'm saying this because, obviously, there shouldn't be a whole bunch of kids playing Grand Theft Auto, right? Oh, I laugh. But... now, here's the cool part. If I can pull it off. And I'm sure if you watch my videos, you've seen this before. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And here we are. And because it's a GTA game, I can get off. Take a look. See, is this my office? I threw my office up higher. But hey, you can see my apartment from here. One of them. And on this note, looking out at the city, I'm going to tell you that basically you could hop into this race, start doing all kinds of stunts. You can kill time more easily here in more fun ways here than you can do an Entourage. If you get a bunch of friends and agree on this and say, look, guys, we're going in here and we're just going to kill it out to the edge for the full 8 minutes. Just wait for your start for the 8 minutes to be up or something like that. Pick any kind of race just so that you can max out the money. Y'all can make the money. I mean, it's just... it's all good times. The more friends you get, the more money. Of course, the guy in last place is going to get, you know, not a lot, but... you know, it's an interesting thing. This thing used to very easily just bounce right the heck off of here. And I don't know what's happened, but lately this has been how it's gone. Come on, get back up. I mean, I've done this hundreds of times where you just zing and you're flying off the thing. Maybe they change the physics around a little bit, or it's just Murphy's Law when you're filming. One trick I like to do is drive road, do the first lap really carefully, then you get the clean lap bonus. Your RP. I'm not too worried about the RP. We're just trying to soak them for some cashola. Whoa! Hey! Wee! Brakes, brakes, brakes. What happened? Oh, here we are. I got lost there for a second. Now, for all I know, in the next video, I'll say, well, here it is. It's the 18th. I bought a shark card. Because I didn't want to miss out on the deals, but... no, don't go through. It's the hero yet, you know. 3 minutes. Another thing I'll do other than riding the walls of the building is zip up this way. I can also see myself get like $59,000 and be 1,000 short of getting the apartment and have it go off sale. I could see that happen. But I mean... I've got an apartment next door, so it's really not... oh, that didn't land well at all, no. Can we go through this gate? Yes, we can! Yay! Through that. See? Mayhem. You can light your bike on fire in the... hey, now that went a little bit better. Zipping up through the woods. One thing I always like to do is see if I can take at least one car. First time I do this, whatever car I'm driving, see if it'll make it all the way up here. The bike will. I mean, this isn't even a question. I forget, is this the Epsilon Center thing, or is it some other kind of place, or... yay, we're here. So what do you guys think about, you know, shark card? I mean, buying a shark card, you know, helps. They're going to keep making DLC as long as they're making tons of money off of shark cards. That's what their motivation is. That's why, you know, that's why you end up with motorcycles that cost as much as a Lamborghini in real life. You know, it's just why the supercars are like, and the race cars are like $3 million. Why? Because you either have to grind forever on that if you really want that, or you get yourself a shark card. Mere fact that my channel's probably making me about one shark card, oh, I don't know, a year, is part of my motivation for... Ugh, you gotta be kidding me, you should have landed that no problem, and there I am dead on the ground. Yeah, it's... Look at it. Look at that. So I hate to say it's been kind of a demotivating money kind of episode. I really hadn't really planned on having it go this way. Here, I'll tell you what I'll do. Let me give you my thoughts on gaming money in a nutshell. This is the 24/7 Freelancer universe. That's right, Microsoft Freelancer. And believe it or not, if you were to ask me, what is your main game? And this is a strange thing to say, because I haven't played this game in quite a while. But this is it. This is Microsoft Freelancer is really, this is the game that made me, it was my first game I ever joined a clan in. A video game clan, not the Ku Klux Klan. This is positive things, the team. And this is where I became lead. I joined the base, where you see base and system services. This is where it came from. And we were you know, a mercenary group, basically. You know, it was basically a justification of trying to steal systems from other people. But, you know, that was our deal. Our main RP was protecting people from players, which were just aggressive jerks who shot at people for no reason. It wasn't even like they were role-playing. They just would shoot people. And there were a lot of them, and that became our RP, and then they started fighting with us, so it became our own thing, and, you know, it was really kind of cool. Ended up leading that, and I've never given up the title, even though, really, I don't know if anybody else in base still has, you know, plays the game or maintains their ships. There's a couple, but, so, if I was going to spend money, I would send it to RoboCop. As a matter of fact, let's see, we can probably, if I'm lucky, and he still has the links up to his PayPal where you can make donations, put that up here. And it's not that I want to get, you know, the Fireball missile, which has all the maneuverability of the Firestalker missile and all the explosiveness of the Cannonball missile, hence Fireball, or, you know, to get a Class 10 Graviton shield or a Class 9, which would go really nicely on one of those Blood Dragon heavy fighters. But the point of the matter is that they have, for $45, you can get a shield or a missile. But this is something where this guy we only know as RoboCop, has been keeping the server going in his living room or wherever he's at for, oh, let's see, 11 years. And I'll be perfectly honest, I have a certain amount of guilt because I haven't done that yet. Because every time I thought, really, want to give RoboCop some DOS here, some money, some Smaholians. There's always something kind of like, oh, yeah, well, we need to get this, or we need to do that, or there's, like, the whole food thing. And, you know, not that I'm, like, you know, starving or anything like that. I'm doing rather well, but it's just, you know how things are nowadays. And so at some point, that's what I'm going to want to do. I'm going to want to take care of RoboCop before I really do any shark cards or anything else like that. I've done one shark card on a GameStop sale just because it was, I wanted to get the Frankensteins, and I didn't have the money. Which, really, I mean, those were exceptionally expensive. Like, really, really, really exceptionally expensive. Incidentally, those two things I noticed you can't... I noted that you can't buy in-game for game cash here. I've got enough cash going, and believe me, this isn't my only account. I must have 50 different ships in this game. Five for... Oh, here we have the telephone. And a wrong number phone call interrupts, but at any rate. So it's not like, you know, I need money in this game to cash out, but it's just, the idea is it's a token thing you get. It doesn't really increase your capabilities that much. But, you know, it's a token, you want to take care of the people, take care of you, and, you know, even if nobody else was playing the game ever again, I'd still want to throw him, you know, if he was going to shut the server down, I'd still feel like I owed him at least one donation. I should have been doing it a lot more than that, because, I mean, I spent a lot of time on the server. And on the old, really where I started out was the Aussie Freelancer server, because I happened just to drift on this Australian server that happened to be loaded up with people when I was playing, when I was available to play. And met a lot of friends there. A lot of us came over here when that server shut down, so I have a feeling that, you know, there's a lot of games that people have thought, this is going to be the next Freelancer. Star Citizen, of course, built by the guy who created Freelancer, is one of them. And I have a feeling that when people try those games, they're going to end up saying to themselves, I really kind of miss the places that I know and the feel of the game that I loved. Because I don't think Star Citizen's going to be exactly, you know, Freelancer on steroids. You know, it's going to have other things in it. It's going to be maybe more than Freelancer, but it's not going to be... There are certain ways it's going to be less. And I think, you know, so far I haven't tried the latest ship-to-ship fighting, but I mean, when I have tried it, it's more realistic, which means it's less fun, if that makes any sense. So I have a feeling that this server hopefully will be hot and populated for a long time. So that's my thought on, you know, RoboCop. If I can get you something as soon as I can, I will. In the meantime, I'm gonna keep trying to make videos and support the place that way. I gotta get back to playing this game, because I'm just looking at the screen right now. I'm flying through the dead of space here. And I'm happier than I was certainly playing Entourage by a great bit. There's something about the atmosphere and the feel of this game. It's just wonderful. I know what you're saying. You're supposed to be in deep space. What's up with the clouds? And it's like, well, no, it's you're in a dust cloud kind of thing. I'm passing off a battleship and a base there. Hey, don't pull a flip on me. Off in the mist. Interestingly enough, I'm neutral to just about every... Well, no, this one, the lane hackers and nomads are okay. These guys don't like me, but they... If the outcasts show up, I might run around, but they don't generally show up in the area that I'm in. Not very often. Doesn't happen too often where I'm at. But I'm surrounded by battleships, so they won't be there very long. I'll say that much. So at some point, we'll have to get back into doing... some Freelancer videos. Maybe I have a bunch on the channel already if you're interested. And so that's where that's kind of... This video went in a different direction. But on this note, this, folks, is the Black Knight. And have a great night, everybody. This is where I became the Black Knight, really. And I started using the tag on Battlefront, Star Wars Battlefront, but this is really... This is where people know me as the Black Knight. It's in Freelancer. I don't even want to stop recording, I just want to watch it dock. I love this game. And there's something about, I love the place that is this game. I have to get back into it. You know, it's a funny thing, when you're doing videos, you try to figure out what videos will be hot, and what videos you can make, and what will work, and... Maybe a couple Roots videos, get back to my roots. Isn't it just beautiful? This is the Black Knight, have a great night, everybody. I'm so close.
The best mechanic in LS do for you.
Give me money. And now... Accommodation, yes! Now I've got $4,000. Is it worth it? Probably not, but still, we have it. Hey, now it's a spawn location! Woohoo! So we'll spawn here. Let's see how that goes. Helicopter pad. Maze bank. Working all night long. All night long. All night. Oh.
You, boss.
I just appeared. Hi. So let's see. Where are these accommodations? How do we get into them? And there you have it. Look, you got the whole bathroom thing going, a bed. Is this the bed? That's kind of, you know, for the fact that I just paid like, I don't know, $600,000 for this, that's not the bed I was hoping for. Yeah, something a little cushier. Didn't want to see, is there a, you can drink rum, you can change clothes, walk into the, oh wait, this is the main office. So you're telling me that all I get for $600,000 is a place to change, a place to drink rum. And a bathroom with no shower. No shower? Are you kidding me? For $600,000, that can't be right. Yep, that's the, this is.
You do know that I've got 2 degrees, both in finance?
Obviously, that's, how else would you have talked me into this? This is just, what we get here. I don't want to sit down, I wonder where that door goes. Alright, you know, I think I have to change my priorities in this game a little bit and start focusing on buying cars. Because honestly, what am I going to be doing in this game, really? I don't care what the money is, I don't really enjoy the, I don't get enjoy getting shot repeatedly to death. I like having the secretary, I like having the office, I love having base over the secretary's desk. It's a nice little doohingy kind of thing, but I don't know. It's more of a symbolic thing, really. It's more. Here are the base. Here's base offices. That's the base bathroom. Let's see, what's this? Is this the base shower? There is a shower. Okay, I thought I was completely screwed here. This, the layout of this is terrible, and
You're looking very sharp, boss.
That's really what I've spent all the money on. That's what I've spent all the money on here. And I have an NPC tell me I look sharp.
What's cooking? Let me know.
Nothing right now and nothing for a while. What she got on her screen? Just a quick letter or something she's just knocking out there. So on this note, ladies and gentlemen, staring at the base again. Man, this is Dakota. I've already said this is the Black Knight. Have a great night.
Did I mention that I have an MBA?